postcards of the hanging. They're painting the passports brown. The beauty parlor is filled with sailors. The circus is in town. Here comes the blind commissioner. They've got him in a trance. One hand is tied to the tightrope walker. The other is in his pants. And the riot squad, they're restless. They need somewhere to go. As Lady and I look out tonight from Desolation Row. Cinderella, she seems so easy. It takes one to know one. She smiles, puts her hands into her back pockets. Betty Davis. Romeo, he's moaning. She belongs to me, I believe. And someone turns and says to him, my friend, you better leave. And the only sound that's left after the ambulances go is Cinderella sweeping up on Desolation Row. Our moon is almost hidden. The stars, they're just pretending to hide. The fortune telling lady has even taken all of the things inside, all except for Cain and Abel and the hunchback of Notre Dame. Everyone is either making love or else expecting. And the good Samaritan, he's dressing, he's getting ready for the show. He's going to the carnival tonight on Desolation Row. Ophelia, she's neath the window. For her I feel so afraid. On her 22nd birthday, she already is an old maid. Now to her, death is quite romantic. She wears an iron vest. Her profession is her religion. Her sin is her lifelessness. And though her eyes are fixed upon Noah's great rainbow, she spends her time peeking into Desolation Row. Einstein disguised as Robin Hood, with his memories in a trunk. Passed this way an hour ago with his friend, some jealous monk. Now he looks so immaculately frightful as he bumped the cigarette, and he went off sniffing drain pipes and reciting the alphabet. You would not think to look at him, but he was famous long ago for playing the electric violin on Desolation Row. Dr. Phil, he keeps his world locked inside of his leather cup, but all of his sexless patients, they're trying to blow it up. His nurse, some local loser, she's in charge of the cyanide hole. She also keeps the cards that read, "Have mercy on his soul." They all play on the penny whistles. You can hear them blow. If you lean your head out far enough from Desolation Row. Across the street, they've nailed the curtains. They're getting ready for the feast. The Phantom of the Opera in the perfect image of a priest. They are spoon-feeding Casanova to get him to feel more assured. Then they'll kill him with self-confidence after poisoning him with words. And the Phantom shouts to skinny girls, "Get out of here if you don't know." Casanova, he's just being punished for going to Desolation. Midnight, all the agents and the superhuman crew go out and round up everyone that knows more than they do, and they bring them to the factory where the heart attack machine strapped across their shoulders. Then the kerosene is brought down from the castles by insurance men who go check like to see that no one is escaping to Desolation Row. Praise be to Nero's Neptune, the Titanic sails at dawn. Everybody is shouting, which side are you on? Ezra Pound and T.S. Eliot fighting in the captain's tower, while Calypso singers laugh at them and fishermen hold flowers. Between the windows of the sea, where lovely mermaids flow, and nobody has to think too much about Desolation Row. About the time a doorknob broke, when you asked me how I was doing, was that some kind of joke? And all those people that you mentioned, yes, I know them, they're quite late. I had to rearrange their faces, give them all another name. Right now I cannot read too well, don't send me no more letters, no, unless you mail them from this.